Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to bind data to an Angular triggerid of Syncfusion. You can either assign the data to the triggerid component using an instance of Data Manager or a simple JavaScript array collection. I will explain these data binding topics in this video in three sections. First, I will show you how to bind the triggerid data from a local data source, then from a remote data source, and finally using an external AJAX request. Now, for the first part, I will proceed to bind an array of local JavaScript objects to the triggerid. Here, the data is present in the same application as it is running. I am using an existing application that was created during my last Getting Started tutorial, and therefore, all the necessary triggerid modules are pre-configured here. You can download this Getting Started sample from the link provided in the below description, and you can also watch my Getting Started video, which I have shared in the YouTube card. In the Getting Started tutorial, we saw how to bind the hierarchical local JSON data by configuring the subtask details to the parent records. Now I will show you how to bind self-referential data, that is the flat data. Open the appcomponent.ts file, import the data from the datasource.ts file and name it sample data. In the appcomponent class, create an object name data of type JavaScript array, and in the ng-onInit method, assign the sample data value to it. Open the file appcomponent.html, assign the data source with the data variable. Now, I will explain you the structure of the flat data used in this sample. Here, the task ID field holds a unique value to identify each object in this data collection. So, in the appcomponent.html file, I will assign this task ID field name to the ID mapping property of the triggerid. Next comes the parent ID field with a value that represents to which parent node it belongs to. Here, this value points to the task ID value of first object. So, this second object will be considered as a child node of first object. Now, I will assign this parent ID field name to the parent ID mapping property of triggerid. In this way, the triggerid ensures that the structure of the data is self-referential and then it will start to establish the parent-child relationship. I am also adding the tree column index property to triggerid and assign the value 1 to show the expand and collapse option in the second column of the triggerid. Using the columns directive, I am defining 4 columns so that I can avoid displaying all the columns on the triggerid UI. In the terminal, let me type the command ng-serve to run the application. You can see the triggerid rendered with self-referential data. Now, I will move on to the second part of the video about binding remote data to the triggerid. Here, I need to make use of the Data Manager component to access the online data service. Data Manager is a component of Syncfusion library that acts as a gateway and interacts with both local and remote data sources. By default, the triggerid will load the remote data on demand in the scenarios like when you expand the parent nodes or when you navigate through different pages. Once the data is fetched from the remote server, data will be cached at the client side to avoid retrieving data every time from the remote server repeatedly. Now, I will open the appcomponent.ts file and import the Data Manager and Web API adapter from Syncfusion EJ data. Create an object for Data Manager and initialize them in the ng-onInit method. To interact with the remote data source, provide the endpoint URL in the Data Manager with the valid service URL. Set the adapter with the Web API adapter object as the service URL passed to the Data Manager is created based on the Web API standards. Now I will replace this local data object with the Data Manager instance. Now I will explain you the structure of the remote data used in this sample. As the triggerid loads the remote data level by level and not as a whole data at once, I need to define a property to represent whether the node is a parent or a child. Before I define that property, here in this data source, you can see the isParent field holds the value true, which indicates that it is a parent node, and if false, it is a child node. This information helps the triggerid to identify the parent nodes from the data source and then draws the expand and collapse button while loading them on demand. So now I will set the triggerid property hasChildMapping with this column name is parent from the data source. I will run the application now, and you can see the tree grid with remote data loaded in it. Let me move on to the third part of the video to show you how to bind data to the tree grid component by sending an external AJAX request. At times, you may need to load data to the tree grid dynamically at runtime instead of initial control load. Say for example, here you can see the tree grid data getting loaded after I click on this button. In this case, you can use the AJAX method to bind data to the tree grid. As I am going to use the AJAX request, in the appcomponent.ts file, let me remove all the Data Manager and Web API adapter related codes now, and I will start to import the AJAX module first. Open the appcomponent.html file, add a button component, and bind a click event to it. Name the button bind data. Let me add the ID as tree grid to the existing tree grid tag, as I need to use this ID for creating tree grid instance. Remove the data source property assignment, as I have planned to bind the tree grid data source dynamically using AJAX request. In the appcomponent.ts file, I will start to define the click event handler of the button by adding a click function. Then I will create an AJAX instance of the type AJAX within it and will pass the action URL name as its parameter to call its post action. Next, call the AJAX send method. In the AJAX success function, I need to assign the data source for the tree grid. Now, using the viewchild decorator, I will create an instance variable for the tree grid of type tree grid component. The need of this tree grid instance creation is to access the data source property of tree grid at runtime. Create an AJAX success function, and within this function, I will assign the data source property of tree grid with the retrieved resultant data. Now run the application. Click the button bind data, and you can see the tree grid loaded with the data retrieved using external AJAX request. Let me summarize some of the main points. I have explained the steps to bind local and remote data. I have explained how to bind the tree grid component data using an external AJAX request. In my upcoming videos, I will show you how to edit, filter, sort, export, and select tree grid data and add templates to the component. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.